everyone. Welcome to today's Farm Bits. Here we are going to discuss about tips to control soil borne diseases. And here with us, Dr. Asha K.M. Welcome, ma'am.
Hello. Welcome.
Can you tell give a brief discussion on this, ma'am? How to control soil borne diseases?
Yeah. Hello, everybody. Today I'm going to give you a few tips or ideas regarding how to control the soil-borne diseases through the application of different plant protecting chemicals and the method of what is a method you need to use to apply those plant protecting chemicals. Before that, let me give you a list of major soil-borne diseases that we observe more commonly in the field, like damping off. It is a most serious soil-borne disease that occur at a very early stage of the crop, that is in the nursery stage itself, at the seedling stage. Later in the field, it comes to the crown rot, root rot, stem rot. Then in the middle age of the crop, it comes to wilt. It includes both fusarium wilt, verticillium wilt, and bacterial wilt, and even root knot nematode, and so on. These are all the major soil-borne diseases which we observe more commonly. Here, in case of these soil-borne diseases, the pathogens which will cause these diseases, they will be present in the soil, and they either directly attack the roots of the plants or the stem of the plant at the ground level, that is at the soil surface level, which is very harmful for the production of crops, because it is going to affect the growth and development of the plant. If it occurs at a very early stage of the crop, means it is going to completely kill the plant at the seedling stage itself. And later, if it occurs at a later stage, means it will affect the growth and development of the plant. It leads to the economic loss to the farmers, because it leads to the reduction in the yield. So we have to effectively manage these soil-borne diseases at the field level. When it comes to the management of these soil-borne diseases in the field level, the first thing is selection of the appropriate type of chemicals. First thing is that one, and the second thing is the method of application. Both are very much important. When it comes to the selection of chemicals or plant protecting chemicals or any pesticides or fungicides, there are numerous, n number of plant protectant chemicals are there, but as per our observation, we have come out with one best combination, that is a metalaxyl 35% at 0.5 gram per liter, along with Bactinosh, again at 0.5 gram per liter. It has found to be the best combination for controlling most of the soil-borne diseases in various cropping system. So this is with respect to chemical. Then coming to the method of application, here, since these are soil-borne diseases, the pathogens will be present inside the soil, so we have to go for drenching of this chemical combination to the soil. We should be very careful that at the around the root zone, we have to apply these chemicals in such a way that the chemical, it should reach the entire root system. Okay. And one more point that we need to keep in mind here at the time of drenching is we have to maintain the dry soil conditions. What happens if there is more moisture in the soil, means it leads to the dilution of the chemical what we have applied. Then the plant, it will not receive the required dosage of the chemical that is required to kill the pathogen that is present in the soil. Yeah. So we have to apply these chemicals in the dry soil condition. On the other hand, sometimes we will not be able to maintain that soil moisture condition. It will not be in our hands, especially during the rainy conditions. Right? Under such conditions, we should go for using more dosage. A place of 0.5 gram per liter, we should go for using 2 to 3 gram per liter of chemical in case of both the chemicals. Okay, this is one thing. And this application was what I said, it is after the incidence of the disease. So we can also go for prophylactic application of these chemicals or prophylactic use of these chemicals in order to control the soil-borne diseases at the later stages in the field. So prophylactic means preventive measures that could be done with for a seed treatment. We can go for seed treatment before sowing the seeds, or we can also go for root dip seedling root dip in these chemicals before transplanting. After treating the roots of the seedlings in these chemicals, we can later go for transplanting of those treated seedlings in the main field, so that we can avoid the incidence of these soil-borne diseases at the later stages in the field. Okay, this is one more thing. And after or once the disease comes to control, you can also go for application of Vihume Plus. It is a organic plant nutrient at a rate of 5 ml per liter. It is going to improve the new growth of the plant. Thereby, the aerial growth and development of plant will be more, and we can expect more yield of the crop. Along with this Vihume Plus, we can also go for application of biopesticides such as Trichoderma viridae, Pseudomonas and Bacillus subtilis. Either any of these or together, all these you can go for application, that is soil drenching only again you can do. That will prevent the further development of any other soil-borne diseases in the soil. So this is regarding the control of soil-borne diseases in various crops.
So many farmers are facing this problem. Hope the video is very helpful. And farmers, please follow this all what ma'am said. And thank you for watching the video. Thank you, Ashima.
Thank you.